So the last Nintendo Direct that just came out was a little on the S side. It wasn't really worth waiting 530 days, but hey, at least we got a whole new Mario Golf coming out.
This is some hype shit.
What? Mario Golf? Man, my last Mario Golf, I would have to say, would be Mario Golf Toadstool Tour. And I was a kid when that came out. And seeing this game just really hit my nostalgia, man. Sure, we got Mario Golf World Tour, but I didn't really pay attention to that game that much, to be honest. Those 3DS Mario sports games, they just didn't sit right with me for some reason. Before we continue this video, make sure to challenge me live in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate every Sunday, where I challenge every viewer in Smash Ultimate one-on-one here on my channel. Remember, it's every Sunday, so see you there. As always, my name is Junior Leva, aka Mr. Awesome, and here is 10 reasons to get hyped for Mario Golf Super Rush. Number 1. Finally, a console Mario Golf. It's been years since the last console Mario Golf. If anything, it's been almost 18 years. Dude, the last one was on the GameCube. It's crazy because I was a kid when that came out. This is July 29, 2003. I was a kid. I didn't even know how to tie my shoes. Granted, I still don't know how to tie my shoes. I knew a lot less back then. I'm super excited because the Switch is the perfect platform for this game. Honestly, the portability and the ability for it to be on the TV makes this Mario Golf a hybrid Mario Golf. It's a game for a whole new generation of kids. I enjoyed it as a kid, and so can my nephews enjoy it as a kid. And you guys probably never played Mario Golf, and you guys would be able to enjoy it with us. It's all very exciting, and I'm hyped for Mario Golf, man. Number 2, it's very technical. Right off the rip in the trailer, the voiceover woman talks about the technical aspects, and they put an emphasis on the wind and terrain. And this is not to say that the previous Mario Golfs didn't have this whole wind and terrain feature, it just feels a bit more in depth here, because I like the emphasis of it. It's really right in your face, and honestly, you can't really be out here playing golf all willy-nilly like I did when I was a kid. If anything, this means that this Mario Golf might be the most golf-accurate game there is. In terms of real-world golf, that is. Dude, you can snipe the golf ball right into the hole for a hole-in-one with this whole scan feature. If that isn't like, what? I don't know what is, dude. I didn't really react to it that much in my initial reaction. But after watching the trailer for like 20 times, I was like, hey, yo. Nintendo's a little out of pocket with this one. This might look overwhelming to get into, but trust me, it's Mario. Nintendo's gonna simplify this to the max, so don't worry. If you're worried about technicality, just enjoy the game. You'll be fine. You'll get the hang of it. Number 3, the golf outfits. I love Modern Camelot for this. By the way, if you don't know, Camelot is the developers of Mario Tennis and Mario Golf. They started this whole sports outfit trend in their games with Mario Tennis Aces, and they're continuing it here. And honestly, now that I think back, it makes no sense for Mario to be in his overalls playing sports. It just does not make sense at all. Nintendo, why was this a thing during the GameCube days? Although, let me backtrack a little bit. Yoshi and Donkey Kong do look the same, but it's because they're low-key animals. I still think Donkey Kong and Yoshi should still put on something because, you know, they gotta cover up whatever they got going on, but it is what it is. They should just take a page from my boy Bowser. My boy Bowser put on some clothes. And lately, my boy Bowser knows how to dress, alright? Bowser got them shoes with the little metal thingy so his claws doesn't come out. Bowser knows what's up. Bowser got some drip on him. Damn, even Wario is out here looking pretty fire with this whole cowboy aesthetic. See that cowboy hat, Mr. Wah-Man? And let me not even mention my boy Waluigi. Look at this boy. They didn't even want to showcase Waluigi. They just had them over there playing in the desert. I see you, my boy. These golf outfits are pretty fire. I can't believe I'm saying this, but damn, do these Mario characters look freaking good. Number 4. Clean visuals. Dude, Mario Golf really benefited from the HD visuals. Totsu Tour looked alright, but World Tour, that didn't look too good. And honestly, looking at this game in comparison to Mario Tennis Aces, they look like they belong together. Come to think of it, Camelot, again if you didn't listen before, the developers of these games, use the Nintendo hardware really well. Especially with like the whole graphics department, I feel like they really juice out the Nintendo hardware for these Mario Sports games. Have you seen the scenery shown in some locales? I'm not gonna lie, they look really, really good for a Mario game. I mean, if you heard the voiceover lady in the trailer, she says the courses are filled with lush natural scenery. And I believe the voiceover lady, cause it looks really freaking nice. Even the user interface for this game looks super clean. I like this HD version of Mario Sports games. It doesn't look Mario-esque at all. If anything, it looks like this could be pulled from like ESPN or something. Number 5. Speed Golf. Move aside, Unreal Engine Mario. For years, I've dreamed of you becoming a thing. And it's now became a thing. Officially. When I saw this mode, I immediately thought of open world Mario Golf. What? Open world? Well, this isn't really the case. It kind of feels like it. Dude, you're running around with other characters. This is kind of dope. I love the concept of the characters running around to their next ball, and it kind of adds the whole emphasis of race to the finish type of thing. And it's so because everyone goes at once. This game looks perfect to play online with your friends. Plus, if you've noticed, you've had to have noticed if you saw the trailer, you can use items to help you traverse around like the ice flower, the star power, and even a Yoshi egg. This must be really fun to use because it gives you specific ways to maneuver through the course. If items are specific to each character, I kinda wanna try them all to see how it is. Alright, we hit the halfway point for this video, and I gotta say, thank you for sticking around this long. My watch time thanks you. But, as per always, in every 10 Reasons video, let's make sure we hit 300 likes for this video. Why? Because it helps YouTube put me on the map. I'm trying to hit 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and this helps the algorithm promote me, so thank you if you like this video. I really, really do appreciate it. Number 6. Multiplayer. This is a no-brainer. There's gonna be multiplayer in this game. It's dope because you get to play up to 4 players with your friends, both locally and online. Like I said, it's no-brainer. Obviously, every Mario Sports game thrives on multiplayer. But I'm honestly excited for multiplayer in the speed golf mode. I think this would benefit the most online. Plus, I get to clown my friends in golf. Is there anything else a man wants in this world besides $1 billion and a happy life? No, there's nothing else. Number 7. Story mode. I love the RPG elements from the handheld Mario Sports games. Especially the Game Boy Advance games. Those kept me hooked when I was a kid, especially when my mom used to go to the hair salon. Oh man, Mario Tennis for the Game Boy Advance had me reeled in with that story mode, man. And I loved it because that specific story mode had original characters. What I don't really like about this story mode is that everyone's from the Mushroom Kingdom, and it kind of feels like the Miyamoto effect is happening again. But hey, whatever, I'll take what I could get. We got story mode. It's an RPG, there's experience points, you can level up your stats as well, and you can play the game however you choose to. I'm just worried this might let me down. But I'm excited, I'm hyped that there is a story mode. Number 8. It comes out very soon. Hey, so I don't know if you noticed, but 2021's going pretty fast. I mean, if you think about it, the pandemic started like 2-3 months ago, right? I'm totally kidding. Trust me, it feels like it did. The pandemic started a year ago, and it's insane. Life is going by too fast. But the game comes out June 25th, 2021. And honestly, that's just 3 months away. You know how fast 3 months goes by? Really, really fast. And what's dope is that you can pre-order the game right now. So if you haven't pre-ordered your Mario Golf, go ahead and do so. Number 9. The promise of several modes. I don't know if you heard the voiceover lady in the trailer, but she did throw in that there was several modes in this game. And that's very exciting if you ask me. So whatever these modes are, the promise of their existence means a good time. So don't let me down, voiceover lady. Number 10. Hybrid Mario Golf. Alright, I mentioned this in the number one reason, but with this Mario Golf, we got the best of both worlds, boys. We got the RPG elements from the handheld games, and we got the beautiful graphics from the console games. And yes, the Nintendo 64 version of Mario Golf is beautiful, alright? Don't at me. You've seen this intro before? Beautiful. Hopefully, this Mario Golf has a banging intro, because that's what we need. This game really makes me appreciate the Nintendo Switch even more than I already have. The Switch allows us Nintendo fans to play games on our 100-inch TVs and our 5.5-inch Switch screens at any time, as long as we have our Switch with us, of course. And it's just such a convenience that me as a kid, I would have loved, man. But yeah, thank you for making it to the end of this video. I hope you guys are hyped for this game as much as I am. If you guys find more reasons to be hyped, let me know in the comments down below. Will you be pre-ordering Mario Golf Super Rush? I know I will. But as per always, shout out to my current YouTube members. You guys put that pizza in my pepperoni. Without your monthly financial support, this channel will not have grown as much as it did these past few months. Especially to those people that subscribed. We hit 10,000 pretty quick. But eventually we're gonna hit 100,000 before the end of the year. I believe it. If you want to support the channel besides subscribing, you can hit the join button and become a member for as low as a dollar a month. That dollar a month goes a long way in the financial world, trust me. Every penny counts. Also, if you don't want to become a member, you can also buy the Mr. Awesome merch, you know, you could be part of these good looking individuals on your screen, and your picture could be featured here as well. Who knows, you probably might look even more stunning with the Mr. Awesome merch on. Drop a like and subscribe for more Super Mario videos. Trust me, I make a lot of them. As always, stay golden.